This is Good Morning Mumbai, and you're with Rishi K.
Wonderful to have the new Formula E racers here, and this is a circuit I'm really, really looking forward to. Come September 2014, Mahindra Racing is going to blaze the tracks, and Karun Chandok, who is one of India's brightest racers, and Bruno Senna are in studio. Karun, what's up, man?
Hi, nice to see you, Rishi, and nice to be in Mumbai.
Yeah. Listen, this is a new uncharted terrain for you with Formula E. So how much testing have you done? How much work have you put into this, man?
So far, zero. You know, as you say, completely new territory for everybody. New championship, new concept. Electric racing is going to be a different adventure, I think, for everybody. But we start testing next week on the 4th of June, and that's the first time. And as you say, it starts out of sync to normal championships, so September as opposed to March. So we have a bit of time to prepare for the season ahead.
Bruno Senna, welcome to India, man.
Nice to be here. First time for me in Mumbai, so enjoy myself. And the weather's been nice, so it's all good.
Well, I got to say this. You guys are mates from a long time ago. Two teams together. This is the third time you're together. Is that the way it is, Bruno?
Can you believe that? We've been teammates in GP2 back in 2008, and then Formula 1 2010, and here we are again, third time lucky, so it's working pretty good.
I'm really happy that here's an Indian team with an Indian driver at the helm of it, you know. But the curious question to you is, why Mahindra Racing?
You know, in this championship, is all about finding the right team, finding the right structure. And I was talking to a few Formula E teams before being reached out by Mahindra. And when these guys told me the project, it was really interesting. You know, they're really motivated to win, motivated to fight for it. And it really convinced me. And so far, they've been doing a pretty great job. I think one of the best jobs out in the paddock. And I think we have a good chance to arrive and go for the top positions of the podium.
What are max speeds here? I know I'm talking like an excited child. What is it? Is it 200, 225 in terms of kilometers?
Yeah, the speed is actually capped at 225 because don't forget we're on street circuits. It's the only championship, I think, that's going to run on all street circuits. So they're going to close the roads. A bit like you have in Mumbai Marathon, I guess, for people just to understand. And that's, I think, one of the big appeals of Formula E. You know, to race in the middle of London or the middle of Berlin or Miami or whatever, it's pretty unique. So I think that's going to be quite interesting.
Mm-hmm. We're going to come back and talk about these guys, their lives, e-racing, a whole lot more. It's Third Eye Blind, Semi-Charmed Life. In a few minutes, we're going to put up pictures of Karun Chandok as well as Bruno Senna in studio. On Twitter, it's at HRISHIKAY. On Facebook, it's the Radio 1 Mumbai Facebook page, which is facebook.com/radioone.mum. Check this song out. Immediately after that, more conversation. Semi-Charmed Life, Third Eye Blind, Bruno Senna. I remember the great Ayrton Senna, your uncle, had once said, after you won a race, you think I'm fast? You got to check out my nephew. Man, I tell you this, he might not be as revered as he is in Brazil and the rest of the world, but there's a loyal fan following here. I mean, there are people here who'd still give an arm and a leg to watch the DVD and reminisce about it and just some memories about your uncle, man. It's so incomplete without talking about him.
Yeah, no pressure for me then, that statement from him. But, you know, it's true. When I came to race in India in Formula 1 a couple of times, people really knew Ayrton, and so many people came to say, man, your uncle was my hero, your uncle was the reason why I follow Formula 1. And, you know, when I was a kid, you know, he was at home whenever it was holiday time, so it was always kind of like fun times, just go-karting sometimes together, jet skiing sometimes together. It was a pretty, relaxed lifestyle. Whenever he was outside of the Formula 1 environment, he was just trying to forget about it, to be honest with you. I think he was so intense when he was working in Formula 1 that whenever he was outside of it, he just wanted to completely forget about it. And I can actually understand it now. And it's interesting to see.
Yeah, and there's a lot of learnings from there, man. I mean, his life is such an example for you and the next generation to feed off. You know, that's awesome, isn't it?
I think so. I mean, looking at the way he approached Formula 1 when he was there, it really changed a lot of the way that the new drivers were coming in. And I think it just shows that Formula 1 has become much more professional after he came, because everybody had to up their games, basically, after Ayrton.
We've got to talk about that legacy as far as you're concerned, Karan Chandok. Vicky Chandok, your dad is actually listening up in the mountains in Kodaikanal.
With your parents.
Hey, Amma, Pa. Hey, Uncle Vicky, Uncle Bandhu, all of you wonderful people out there. Now, here's a legacy, yeah? It's not like acting and asking an actor's son, saying, man, you know, your dad was an actor, so you're in the movies. This is much more detailed, because this is a technical skill, man. So growing up as Vicky Chandok's son, the family, racing as a little boy, talk about that and where it led you on to.
Well, obviously, I mean, as you say, I grew up in a racing family. My dad, my granddad, my grandmother also used to do some races. So, you know, my weekends were spent going to rallies and racetracks all across the country. You know, they never had the opportunity to really race at an international level, I think apart from Sri Lanka, perhaps. So, you know, it's been an eye-opening experience for all of us. And particularly coming from India, you know, there's really... We've only had two Formula One drivers and really two of us who've climbed the ladder all the way through. And it's, you know, we've spent today, yes, as you say, a lot of people know about F1 and know about drivers and teams and racing and championships. But I've been to meetings with media and with sponsors and people, and you have to explain the difference between a go-kart and a Formula One car, yep. You know. And so there's been a huge process where I think people like Naren and I have had to really educate the public, the media, and the corporate people about the sport. And we've done that, I think, quite well over the last decade or so, to a point where, you know, I think collectively there's quite a good fan base and a knowledge base on F1.
You'd be very proud to know that at 94.3 Radio 1, the problem is that guys like Naren and yourself and some of the other contemporary Indian riders are so busy traveling the world that we can't get you into studio every single week. But we do have Hurma Sorabji, you know, who's editor of Autocar India magazine, who comes every single week and he just talks us through the sport, man. And I think that's so important because everybody, it's easy to promote cricket and football, you know, because Everybody's doing it. And Formula One and motorsport in particular needs so much more. Bruno, you got to talk us through some more of the rules in e-racing, man. So, two cars, yeah? And how does it work? Because, hey, it's about the battery being charged, right?
Yeah, so if people don't need to learn a bit more about motor racing, then they'll have certainly a big learning curve for Formula E. All the cars are electric, full electric, so there's no combustion engines in it. And, well, battery technology is still a bit in its infancy, so we're going to have two cars. Each driver will have two cars per race, so you start the race with one car. Halfway through, or depending on when your battery depletes, and then try to finish the race with the other car. Of course, if you drive just flat out, your battery will deplete before the end of the race, so that's not a good strategy either. You have one type of tire, that's it. You don't have, like, Formula 1, you have different compounds, tires for the dry, tires for the wet. In Formula E, you have one type of tire. This is much more like a road tire than anything else. And, yeah, we're going to have a few drivers in the all street circuits, which will be quite interesting. Everything happens on a Saturday as well. Yeah. We drive practice.
You mean
session.
It's a qualifying practice? Everything is on the same day.
Practice, qualifying, and race on the same day.
Oh, mamma mia!
Which means that on a street circuit, I think we'll see a few drivers not starting the races because of some damage to their cars.
I can imagine.
Hopefully, we're not one of those.
Hopefully. Okay, Poker Face, Lady Gaga, post us some messages and then we're back with the boys. You know that after every two talk sections, we go into some messages, but use this time fruitfully. Yeah? You want to ask them any questions? Want to reach out to the boys? It's at HRISHIKAY on Twitter, facebook.com/radio1.mum on Facebook. One space to query and name to 53650, the SMS line. Take care of yourself. Till we're back. Karan Chandok. And the wonderful Bruno Senna, Mahindra Racing, Formula E is here.
This is Good Morning Mumbai, and you're with Rishi K. Radio
1. Yes, an Indian team is in Formula E. This is the big exciting stuff this summer. And Bruno Senna and Karan Chandok are the drivers. We're running through, let's take some of your queries, yeah? Chetan Thakkar, do these cars run on battery packs or hydrogen fuel cells? I think they pretty much answered that. What about engine noise like an F1? And here's the interesting part. Will the cars swoosh by? Lack of the V8 engine noise in F1 this year has already made it extremely boring. Sorry, but I couldn't help but laugh at that. Karan, answer that. So, in terms of decibels.
Yeah, I mean, I think, obviously, we're not going to have the noise of an engine because there is no engine. We're running on battery packs. So, yes. I think it's, obviously, it's going to be quiet compared to what traditional racing fans are used to. But I think what you have to keep in mind is that's why we can run in city centers. I know in India we don't have noise restrictions in urban areas and things like that.
Yep.
But in most Western countries they do. And that's why Formula One, for example, can't run on city streets in a lot of countries, whereas we can, you know, so we can run in the heart of cities, and that makes it possible. Well, basically, we're taking the race to the fans rather than asking the fans to come to the race, because you're taking it to the, you know, a guy can open his apartment windows, look down, and we'll be racing below him. Wow. And that's pretty cool, I think. So, and I don't agree with his comment about F1 being boring because of the lack of noise. Because first of all, I mean, we've heard the cars. They don't really sound that bad.
Yeah. It's just that they won't blow your ear off.
They won't blow your ear off. And I agree, that is part of the spectacle.
Yeah.
But I don't, I mean, I don't watch F1 because of the noise. I watch F1 because I think the cars are amazing to watch and the racing is great to watch. So if they sound a bit different, you know, too bad.
I actually went online and there was an e-car which was going around a racetrack. I think it was a test drive. I don't know whether it was Luca Di Grassi or who was testing it. But it's pretty loud, man. And it said somewhere there that it's about 50 dB lower in terms of decibel level. But it was pretty loud for an electric car, certainly. So, Bruno, now spill the beans. How is it that you have changed Karun Chandok's eating habits?
Yeah, it's one of those things that you don't expect teammates to do. But Karun used to be a vegetarian, much like his mother. Mm. And I think she didn't like me very much at the beginning, because I think a couple of months after we became teammates in 2008, Karun tried his first steak, beef. And since then, he's not being a vegetarian anymore. So I think, yeah, his mom likes me now, but I don't think she liked me very much then.
It's like the tiger who has tasted blood. I want to know, you know, how he's influenced you. I know how he has influenced you, and I want to know, Bruno, how Karun has influenced you. And if you're not going to answer that, and you've got that smug expression in your face, Karun, how have you influenced him?
Well, I think the first time, it was again early 2008, and probably our first race weekend in Dubai. I remember we went to, I have some family there, we went home for dinner, and Bruno's mum and his whole family were there, and we had Indian food, and they were all standing, all just sweating and eating loads of raita and yogurt because they couldn't handle it. But we went out last night, and he's come on a bit. You know, it's taken 6 years, but he was doing okay last night when we went out for dinner. So yeah. I think I've influenced his Indian eating habits a little bit as well.
Yeah, it's working for me. I had a great meal last night. Karun tried to also make me more organized together with my family. But the Brazilian bomb continues to be...
Oh, God, they are the messiest people on the planet. I tell you, that's the worst thing of being his teammate. His rubbish is lying all over the place, you know?
No, my stuff is actually not so bad, but when my family comes, they just... It looks like a bomb has exploded inside a truck, and there's just stuff everywhere. It's too many women.
I love you guys. I tell you, this is not the first time I've had a motorsport duo in here. Adrian and Paul were sitting in the same two seats that you guys are sitting in, and this is a massive compliment.
Yeah, but they're boring, though, aren't they? Let's be honest,
brother. That's exactly what I was coming.
Yeah,
Paul. This interview, I mean, that one was not a patch on this one, man. I mean, they're lovely blokes. Don't get me wrong, both Adrian and Paul. But this is something else. This is unbelievable. Thank you for coming by. More conversation up ahead. It's Michael Bublé, Hollywood. My name is Rishi K. 931, the Mahindra Racing Boys, Formula E kicks off, and we're part of it.